The aquarium we will be setting up today is 4 feet long, 2 feet wide, and 2 feet tall, containing 120 gallons, just like the several other tanks along the same wall. Before we begin though, we should start from the beginning and go over the plan. Originally, I wanted a center-focused scape, with all manzanita wood in the center, pointing out in all directions, using plants that need little to no maintenance. Something was off though, it was just too busy and no real room for plants around it. So I switched directions. I decided to split the scape into two halves. Ugh, I didn't like it either. I've done too many scapes just like it already. So back to the original plan, yet use less wood. In fact, I restricted myself to using only 5 pieces of wood. A lot of you guys always tell me, and I say it sometimes, less is more. The wood isn't going to stand up by itself or look perfect without some help, so I tend to use large stones to not only weigh them down in case they float for the first few days, which happens a lot of the times, but to also ensure they stay in the position intended. The real challenge here, though, is working with the background. Once again, we need to create something that matches it in texture, shape, and color. So I have to try to keep this in mind the whole time. Even though these backgrounds from aquadecorbackgrounds.com are absolutely stunning, a lot of the times, for me, I've found it can be difficult. No, you know, I enjoy the challenge of matching them. Anyways, my vision was to have the center only planted densely. Not only among the wood, but on it as well. Once matured, we'd have a very lush centerpiece with a few branches sticking out. I could just picture a bunch of really cool fish swimming in and around it. I'm really excited about the stocking phase, which we're going to get to here shortly. Now, I'm a huge fan of creating shadows and overhangs as well, so I tried to focus on making the wood lean forward, more so than stand straight up. Yet, still get it to fill most voids. I wanted the wood to almost reach the surface. With the wood in place and stones weighing them down, it was time for plants. I should mention, because I get this question daily, for all my fellow Canadians out there, I bought all these plants from that are seen in this video from aquascaperoom.ca. I've done a few orders with them at this point, so I feel confident in recommending them. Anyways, I started with Anubias barteri, the variation Nana, basically the nano Anubias that is incredibly popular, and I absolutely love it. This stuff was attached to lava rock. These add a different texture, are easy to keep, need little to no maintenance, and can be planted anywhere in the tank. This isn't a plant that requires a substrate, so we can put it on rocks, we can put it on wood, we can put it on whatever we want, really. Now, you'll notice that I tried to focus on covering the stones, weighing the wood down, with the lava rock. The general plan was to plant from the center out. As opposed to just sporadically planting, I wanted to make sure I had enough plants going from the center all the way out and let them get less dense as they travel outwards. Then, of course, some planted tank substrate added in advance so I could begin planting the other plants while not having to worry about accidentally covering them up later. The next plant used is also an all-time favorite of mine. You'll notice that I like easy-to-keep plants that require little to no maintenance, and this entire scape is focusing on that. I went with the Microsorum, the Java fern, basically, except this is the Windelof. Once again, an easy-to-keep plant that generally needs no maintenance or even a substrate, meaning I could plant this almost anywhere in the tank and have some success, including gluing it to the wood. This fern grows to be more spread out and more bushy, which is exactly the look I was looking for. I also want to point out that as the scape progresses in this video, you'll notice the contrast in the greens that we're using on the plants, as well as the shape and textures. They begin to look really good. I think it's important to mix and match when you can, yet stay along the same theme intended. Thank you. And with that said, the next plant up was the Cryptocorin crispatula. This is a very interesting plant. I mostly planted this in the center though. The hope here is that it grows taller than the center of the wood, blocking off visuals to like how the wood was formed and connected, and really making this scape pull together as planned. This also tends to be a plant that requires no real maintenance, going along with the predetermined theme. I had a little bit of narrow leaf Java fern as well, and I focused that around the back of the tank. Both the narrow leaf and the Cryptocorin both tend to have longer narrow leaves, so the hope here was to see if we can get them to intertwine slightly, offering a bit of color and texture contrast between the two. If it works out, I think it's gonna look really cool. I'm really excited about this scape, as all I really have to do here after all the equipment is installed and the tank is stocked is do my water changes. A very simple yet beautiful scape that's not going to require a lot of maintenance. We can simply just watch it mature and enjoy it. I think what I might end up doing here as well is cap the planted soil with a white sand. But I wanted to get your opinion on it first. I'd also like to hear your suggestions for stocking this tank. What it might be, as well as your overall opinion on this setup. I'm not going to go any further with this until we get that. What you see now is now, it's basically filled with water at this time, and it's been up and running for a short while. Plants are taking hold and whatnot. But before we go any further with it, I definitely want to hear what you guys think about me capping the sand off, or so the planted soil off, as well as stocking options. Anyways, if you enjoyed this tank and this video, I make these videos all the time. If you're not subscribed to this channel yet, you certainly should if you don't want to miss any of them. I'll see you guys in the next one.